Okay, I am heading out. Going to make a quick stop and then head back to my house so I can pick up my son. Very, very excited to see him. It's so funny because as much as I miss him this weekend, knowing that he was having fun, I already talked to him twice. It wasn't too bad. But with him going away to see his dad for basically a month, like Jesus. Well, really 3 weeks because he leaves on a Thursday. He's going June 6th. So I don't really, that's basically the weekend to me. So that week's already gone. And then he comes back the 29th, which is a Saturday, but I think I'm going to tell his dad to bring him back that Friday on the 28th because I don't want him to come back the 29th and then he goes away to another camp the 30th, which is that Sunday, and he's gone for another week. So I want to see my baby. I'll miss him. Yeah. I'm so tired. You're going to be so tired like you have like a horrendous headache. What did I do with my vitamin water? Oh. This right here, it's the drink for champions. It really is. Did I put my medicine in here? Yeah, I keep Tylenols on standby at all times. Ooh. What was I gonna say? Hold up. It's very chilly today. It feels like it's only maybe like 55, 60 degrees. And a lot of my clients went to a cookout today and had on sundresses and it's one thing like if you're at somebody's house, but to be at a park and you're kind of like stranded and stuck. No, I would definitely freeze. But anyway, oh, I found out my son, my oldest, one of the twins, that he has a job, like first time working ever. And I honestly feel that he finally decided to get a job is because I also stop enabling him. You know, he wouldn't do what he's supposed to do, but you know, every time I would see him or talk to him, I would try to make sure he always had money. He goes through money like crazy though. But I feel if, you know, other people around him was still like really, really looking out for him like they used to, you know, I don't know, you know, what his dad did for him. But I know I was one of his big enablers as far as giving him money. I remember when he was staying with me 2 summers ago and I told him he would have to get a job and he looked at me like I hit 16 hits. Not even 6, not even 4, not even 2, but like 16 hits. And I expressed to him like during football season, as long as you keep your grades up, you'll be fine. But when football season's over, January 2nd, you know, I want you working. You know, but hey, I'm just glad he's finally working and it'll make him appreciate his money more. And I bet you when he get his first paycheck, he won't be so quick to spend $50 in one sitting, you know, with just buying things, you know, when someone else is giving you $200, that could be gone in 5 minutes. But when you work for that money, you're gonna be like, where's the sale rack? Or is there a 2-for-1? Yeah, so, you know, it was a long time coming. He's a, wait, sophomore. I had to get it right. Freshman, sophomore. He'll be a sophomore going to college this summer. So I'm happy about that. I've been praying for his safety. I left him a message just saying that I'm praying for him and, you know, bullets don't have a name. Be careful where you go and who you hang out with. You know, he didn't, you know, get back to me. But if I left him a message saying, you know, son, call your mom. I have some money for you. That boy would probably woke up out of his sleep. Mommy, 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 where you at? Where you at? But growing pains, I guess. Growing maturity pains. Yeah, because from some of the things that I found out, you know, at least, what, 10 of his friends have been shot and killed in a matter of like maybe 2 years. Like 10, literally. That's a lot. You know, and it's always like, you know, he was just with that person maybe like a day before or... And I'm like, wake up, God. He's not trying to tell you something. He is telling you something. And that's like, God, please keep my son covered. You know, but I'm not going to go into a tangent with that as well. Just going to pray for him and amen. Pray for my daughter and amen. Pray for myself and amen. Pray for family and loved ones, family and friends and amen. Whatever is going to happen, you know, God for... seen it already, so I'm just praying that everyone is ready when he comes. When he calls my name and my number, I pray that I'm ready. I want to make it in. And hopefully my loved ones will as well. Yeah, that's about it. Go pick my baby up, make my couple stops. Try my best not to buy anything. Yeah. I need to be, like, handcuffed, like, my wallet to my purse. So, maybe I'll just buy some more covers. See, I'll make excuses like that. Oh, I need more phone covers. Like, no, I don't. But, alrighty, have a good Memorial Day. I'm going to, not focus on food. I might even go back to the gym again. I wish my son was old enough to get into the gym that I go to, LA Fitness. They say you have to be at least 13. He turns 11 on Friday. He looks 13 now. But if I can get someone, if they don't make me like show his birth certificate and things like that, I think I just may do it. If I can just sign them up, if they just want the money, amen, I just might do it. Yeah, I just might do it. I can get away with it. Alrighty, peace and blessings. God bless. Have a good day. Okay, bye-bye.